it doesn't actually act like that.
No, it does not. It does not. What it does is it injects retransmission. It doesn't infect acknowledgments.
By that time, wouldn't the corresponding node timer would be out and it'll send it back again?
So the idea is that this timeout is way shorter than the end-to-end timeout. Otherwise, yeah, it doesn't work. So if a packet is lost to fading, the access point sees no ACK, it will then retransmit the packet from its own buffer. So presumably, if this happens fast enough, quick, the mobile will get the packet, and returns an ACK, before the TCP timeout. So, the good news about this is that the AP never acknowledges packets. Entity that's entitled to acknowledge the packet is the mobile node at the end. So therefore, if an acknowledgement travels back to the corresponding node, that's because the mobile node actually got that packet. So this fixes the problems in indirect TCP. So the advantages are basically the converse of the indirect TCP disadvantages. So complicated handoffs are not needed, and access point crash is non-catastrophic. Furthermore, all acknowledgments are acknowledgments from the mobile node. So if the mobile node acknowledges all of the packets in a file, that means the mobile node actually got all of the packets in the file. So what you can do with the fact that complicated handoffs are not needed, that gives you the choice. So you can either argue that if the two access points are close to each other and there's a high bandwidth length between them, you can transfer the entire state of the TCP connection from one to the other and just keep it alive. Or if that's not true, if it's not feasible to transfer the entire state of the TCP connection from one to the other, you can simply start dropping packets and have them retransmitted. So that would result in a slow start, but you should be able to tell the difference between whether it's more advantageous to transfer the state or not transfer the state and just go for the slow start. So basically, you have the freedom to do that. Access point crash is not catastrophic. If the access point crashes, it doesn't matter because the access point is not holding any irreplaceable information. The disadvantages. So for one thing, isolation of the wireless link is less effective. So you, if you happen to have a situation in which so one consequence of this is that the access point timeout must be much smaller than the TCP channel. So if you happen to have a channel in which that's not true, then basically this method is unusable. Or if they're close to each other, then the fact that this that the two sides of the network are not isolated from each other starts to play a role. So for example, if let's say the TCP timeout is a second, and the access point timeout is half a second, and you lose two packets in a row, then the TCP link will reset. Question.
Is the mobile node aware of the access point doing all these things?
I guess it depends. So, in Snooping TCP, it does not happen. So, in indirect TCP, because some kind of custom solution is on the last link, it has to be aware.
This one,
not necessarily.
So, when the mobile node sends in that saying pre-transmission request, does the access point kind of not forward the pre-transmission ahead, or does it temporarily depend?
I see. So basically, control messages other than I don't know. Right, so the idea here is that the end-to-end connection is valid. So presumably if there's any control messages that are meant to go all the way back to the CN, they would not intercept it. So the only thing we're trying to avoid here is we're trying to avoid packets that are dropped because it's fading. We're trying to avoid them causing a slow start. So all we want to do is if we detect a situation in which a packet is dropped on the last link, and we interpret that as noise, as a result of noise or fading, all the access point has to do is re-inject that packet. So I don't see a reason why any other facet of the end-to-end connection would be
messed. Basically, if I do manage to get my retransmission request through, then the support destroys the.
Would I even have a retransmission request in there? Like, or would I just wait? Like, because obviously there will be a timeout period, right?
See, I'm going to send it before we.
I'm not.
As long as the MN does not send it back, that means automatically.
That's correct. Yeah. So, what I'm wondering, I can't remember if negative acknowledgement is actually a valid TCP message or a retransmission request. I'm not sure if there's an end-to-end retransmission request that's like that, other than timeout.
I think it is like if the packet is received, but the packet is files the error.
Okay, maybe in that case.
It acts the last properly received segment.
I see. Okay. So everything that this is set up is under the assumption that if there's a problem with the packet, it's wrong.